I'm going to describe what we mean by segregated flow in chemical reactor and to discuss how it affects conversion. Because depending on what assumptions we make about mixing on a local scale, micro mixing, we can end up with different conversions, different calculations of conversion for the same reactor. So first, I need to define what I mean by complete segregation. Complete segregation, referring to molecules of the same age group. In other words, molecules that enter together and they're going to spend 1 minute, for example, in the reactor, will stay together for that minute and leave. And these are small packets of molecules, and they don't get diluted by mixing with other packets. So how much reaction occurs in a given packet depends on the residence time of that packet. And of course, for ideal or real reactor, we have some sort of residence time distribution that we then use to look at how these packets react and how much time they have to react. So an example that might make it easier to visualize these packets that are small on a macro scale but contain many molecules is if we had laminar flow of a viscous fluid in a tubular reactor. Or if we had two immiscible liquids, for example, that were reacting in a CSTR, such as a polymerization reactor. So I tried to schematically represent that here of the green circles representing one of the fluids and then the rest, the continuous phase, representing the other fluid. And this is how some types of emulsion polymerization would be carried out. And so these green dots, which are small, and I just exaggerated the scale here just for visualization, these green dots then don't mix with each other, and how much reaction occurs in a given packet of molecules is a function of what's the residence time distribution. How long does a given packet of green molecules, if you like, spend in the reactor? Well, the way we might model this, if we want to consume, we have complete segregation and we want to create a mathematical model, is to think of the reactor as consisting of a large number of plug flow reactors in parallel. So this again is a schematic representation where I've just drawn a few plug flow reactors, but if you think of these as a small number of representation, a very large number of plug flow reactors where the different lengths correspond to different residence times, then the lengths for our given reactor we would obtain from a measurement of residence time distribution. And then we could calculate the conversion or the concentration leaving the reactor for each of these plug flow reactors, assuming they're just ideal plug flow reactors. In contrast to segregated flow, we have complete mixing, and complete mixing will give us a different conversion. For example, for the same residence time distribution from segregated flow. And so the difference depends on what's the order of the reaction. So for example, if I have a rate of reaction for component A and N equals 2, then segregated flow will give a higher conversion in contrast to micro mixing. If I have order N equals 1, now it's the same. It doesn't matter which model, we're going to get the same conversion. And we can help visualize this. And so first, if we want to be more general, N greater than 1, then segregated has the higher conversion. Likewise, N less than 1, micro mixing would have the higher conversion. So if we wanted to visualize this, we could look at just two elements of fluid. One a concentration C1, the other a concentration C2. And for segregated, the average rate for the packet, we have two packets, would be the rate constant. Concentration in the first packet squared, likewise for the second, divided by 2. For mixing, and again this is micro mixing, be the rate constant times the average concentration, because we're going to think of mixing these together and then having the reaction. Of course, this we can expand, and I'll expand the K over 4, C1 squared plus C2 squared plus 2C1 C2. And if I want to make a comparison, I could, for the segregated flow, multiply the top and the bottom by 2. So I have K over 4, C1 squared plus C2 squared plus C1 squared plus C2 squared. And so if we want to compare now these two, of course this term is the same in both, but if we have the second order reaction like we're looking at here, then C1 squared plus C2 squared is greater than 2C1 C2. And this would then mean we have the higher rate for segregated flow. And the easiest way to understand, think about this, is just put some numbers in. For example, if this was 5 squared and this is 2 squared, that's 29. And the right side, 2 times 5 times 2 is 20. And so we have a higher rate for the case of segregated flow. In fact, we have different rates and therefore different conversions in a reactor depending on where we assume segregated or mixing, then this means the residence time distribution is not sufficient for us to determine conversion in a reactor. So if we have a non-ideal reactor and measure the residence time distribution, we could have the same residence time distribution for different combinations or different types of reactors. Same residence time distribution, but different conversions. And a good example is CSTR and plug flow reactor in series. So if I have a CSTR first and then a plug flow reactor, compared to a plug flow reactor and a CSTR, these have the same residence time distribution. But for a second order reaction, this system is going to give us the higher conversion. So the residence time distribution is not sufficient. We have to know something about the system. So we start with segregated flow and micromixing as the two extremes of what sort of conversion we might get.